Thank you, Madam Chair, for allowing me to take the floor. I mean, it's clear that the issue of a conflict of interest of Prime Minister Babiš is very important to the members. And Madam Commissioner, I have to say that I cannot quite agree with the interpretation that the prevention of conflict of interest is 100% a responsibility of the member states. So the financial regulation says that this obligation includes the national authorities, but is by no means limited to them. So it applies to any persons involved in budget implementation, audit, or control. So my interpretation would be that very clearly this includes the European Commission. So I want to stress in that respect that, of course, when the Pirate Party and Transparency International addressed the Commission about this case, it was specifically also because they didn't expect too much help from national authorities, considering that the person under investigation is the Prime Minister. And regarding the question of Mr. Babiš' involvement as the controller of Agrofert, the Pirate Party had to go to the Slovakian registers of companies in order to find the necessary information, because this information was not available from the Czech authorities. So I would like to ask specifically about a meeting that, according to my information, you took with Mr. Babiš on September 6, namely whether during this meeting you discussed the question of the subsidies paid to Mr. Babiš' company Agrofert, and also whether you discussed the implementation of the cohesion policy in Czech Republic and the Commission's proposal for the upcoming cohesion policy. And considering that the Commission does have an obligation under Article 61 of the financial regulation to prevent conflict of interest and to address any situation that may be perceived as such, what actions you took in this meeting with Mr. Babiš to take appropriate measures. And secondly, considering that the Pirate Party has found that Mr. Babiš is both the settler and the beneficiary of the trust fund managing Agrofert's asset, it is my legal interpretation that Mr. Babiš is the person controlling the company Agrofert within the meaning of the directive on the mandatory automatic exchange of tax information. So do you agree with this interpretation, or do you see any possibility that, despite the fact that a clear reference is made that controlling persons includes the settlers and the beneficiary, is there any way that Mr. Babiš could be considered not to be the controller of Agrofert? Thank you very much.
Așa cum am fost într-adevăr pe 6 septembrie în Republica Cehă, este o țară importantă pe care ne bazăm. Am avut o întrevedere cu primul ministru, nu cu un președinte de companie, și am discutat, nu am stat nicio secundă singură cu primul ministru, am fost împreună cu colegii mei de la DG Regio pentru a discuta despre necesitatea accelerării implementării programelor și necesitatea vitală pentru noi de a se ajunge la un acord în cadrul Consiliului de anul viitor, pe timpul președinției române la Sibiu, la un acord privind cadrul financiar multianual. Nerealizarea unui acord ar însemna întârzieri și mai mari decât în actuala perioadă de programare în implementarea proiectelor. Acestea au fost subiectele de discuție, după care știți foarte bine că am răspuns foarte direct și deschis întrebărilor din Parlamentul Ceh. Acolo am discutat cu reprezentanții Partidului Piraților, i-am informat despre această întâlnire și am spus încă o dată, noi acum evaluăm acest caz, avem timp până în ianuarie de a oferi răspunsuri la întrebările pe care le-am primit, deci din păcate nu am mai multe informații de a oferi. Mâine, așa cum spunea doamna președintă, veți avea o întâlnire aici pe acest caz concret care, repet, nu vizează fondurile de care sunt eu responsabilă.